family. So today's video is going to be a Q&A. I asked you guys over on my Instagram to send in any questions you have. I figured I would film an updated one for my YouTube family. If you don't have me over on Instagram, I highly recommend you go over there and follow me because I actually answer questions from you guys every single Friday. I do Friday chats over there every Friday. That way you guys can like stay in the loop of what's going on and I can chat with you guys because I always love talking with you guys. So I figured for my YouTube family, since some of you guys don't have me on Instagram over there, I would film this updated one for you guys. So I have quite a bit of questions, so I'm gonna just go through them. Any pregnancy cravings? Yesterday, I had the most randomest craving for Thanksgiving food. I don't know why, but yesterday, I just really wanted like some turkey and stuffing, green bean casserole, yams, mashed potatoes. Oh, it just sounds so good. Like, I'm dreaming about Thanksgiving right now because all of that food just sounds so good to me. So that's like one of my cravings right now, which is so random. Where did Benny go? So if you don't have me on Instagram, then you have no idea what this question is referring to. So as you guys know, Benny is in the military. He's in the Air Force and he had to leave. So he's actually been gone for a few days now. So it's just been me and the girls. For privacy reasons, I don't want to say like where he went, where he's at, all of that stuff. I will have him chat with you guys whenever he gets back on like where he was and how things were. Will you review some more clues about baby girl's name and middle name? No, no more clues. A lot of you guys have already guessed baby girl's middle name because me and Benny already like basically gave you guys like the biggest hint ever for her middle name, which was like her middle name basically means rainbows. So a lot of you guys have actually guessed baby girl's middle name, but as far as like her first name goes and stuff, we don't plan on giving any hints. I will reveal her name in the birth vlog. I'm not gonna make you guys wait any longer. I'm not gonna drag her birth vlog on for like three different videos and then do the name reveal in a separate video. I'm pretty sure we're going to just reveal it in our actual birth vlog. So once baby girl is here, you guys will meet her. You guys will know her full name. Next question is, do you plan on moving into a bigger house? Not anytime soon. I don't see the house we're in now being our forever home. I have goals for our family. The ultimate goal is to buy land and build like our forever home from the ground up. That would be an absolute dream. So I don't see us being in this house forever, but I definitely plan on being in this house for at least like a couple years, maybe longer than 5 years. I'm not 100% sure. You guys know Benny's in the military, like I said. So there's always a possibility that they could just move our family and then we won't be able to be in this house. But long term, I definitely don't see this being our forever home. How long is Benny gone for? Will he miss baby girl's birth? So like I said, for privacy reasons, I don't want to say like where Benny went, how long he'll be gone, all that stuff. But I will say he will 100% be here for baby girl's birth. He isn't going to be gone for that long. It's kind of like a quick trip where he went. So it's not like a deployment or anything like that. So Benny will actually be back really soon. How do you deal with hate comments if you get any? So we actually do get some hate comments. For the most part, we get really positive comments, but we do receive hate comments just like any other channel. You guys just don't really see them because I monitor our comments. And since we are a family channel, I do have like restrictions set up for our comments. That way, if somebody says like a negative word, if they say like a hate word, or if they say like a cuss word or something, that comment automatically gets flagged and it doesn't get posted. So I do have settings on our comments where if somebody says something negative, like I said, I have to either approve the comment or just delete it and then it never gets posted. I'm not gonna lie though, guys, sometimes I do let the hate comments get to me, especially when it comes to comments about Everly. People can be really mean, people can be really nasty, but I try my hardest not to let them get to me. But when it comes to my kids, I kind of turn into like a mama bear and I just want to protect them. But a lot of times whenever we do receive hate comments, it comes from people who aren't even following us, people who don't know us, people who aren't even subscribed, people who don't even watch our videos. So it's just a waste of time going back and forth with somebody who doesn't even know our family, somebody who doesn't even keep up with us. So most of the time, I would say like 99% of the time, I just delete, block that person, hide them from our channel. That way they can't comment anymore. So a lot of the times I just, you know, delete it, just don't look at it. But sometimes, I'm not gonna lie, it does get to me and I just vent to Benny about it. But most of the time, just block and delete. That's just the way to go. Don't feed the trolls. Do you plan on getting a job in the future or continue being a stay-at-home mom? So I am actually doing my job right now. I make money from YouTube videos. I get money from Google AdSense, and then I also make money by working with different companies. So like doing sponsorships or collabs, maybe like shouting out a company or product placement in the background. I make money through that as well. And then I also do get a commission off of sales through affiliate links. Are you nervous about labor? 100% yes. I am also so excited for labor. I know some people find this weird, but labor is like the most exciting part for me. Like just going into the hospital and giving birth to your baby. It's obviously painful, but giving birth is just so exciting to me, and I actually like love being in the hospital and giving birth. I just think it's such a beautiful experience, but definitely this time around I am 100% nervous, especially because you guys know I gave birth to Everly and then she passed away shortly after. So I definitely do have nerves going into it this time around, but just like the thought of being in the hospital again kind of makes me nervous. Like I feel like it's just going to bring back all of these memories and all of these feelings of when I went into labor with Everly. So I'm definitely nervous for it, but I'm also like really excited just to meet her and hold her. Do you guys want more babies? So this is probably the number one question that I get asked all the time. Do we want more babies? Are we gonna try for a boy? And the answer is no. I think I'm done having babies. I say I think because I never want to say never. We are still young. There's still time to have more babies if we want them. So I don't ever want to say definitely 100% no more babies. But as of right now, at least for like a couple years, I do not want any more babies. And I think Benny feels the same way too. Pregnancy is just so much harder on me, especially because this is a pregnancy after loss, and I feel like pregnancy will never be the way it was with Layla and Aurora. I just have so many more fears now and so much more anxiety like going into my appointments. So pregnancy is not only like mentally harder on me now, but it's also physically harder too. This is my fourth pregnancy. This is my fourth child that I've carried. It's just a lot. Like that's a lot on a woman's body. So I feel like if we do plan on having more babies, I don't want babies at least for a couple years. I need a break. My body has just been through so much. Do you guys want any pets? So honestly, if it were up to me, I would say no pets like ever. But Benny and the girls are always begging me for a dog, and I can't, at least not right now. We're about to have another baby. I homeschool Layla. Aurora is gonna start school pretty soon. So I just have my hands full, and the thought of getting a puppy and having to house train them and potty train them and take them out for walks, it's just, I just can't do it. Like I'm just so exhausted thinking about it. The girls' grandpa was actually talking to them about getting like a betta fish. So I will settle having a little fishy, but as far as like a bigger pet goes, I just can't do it. And then also too, I developed allergies really bad. You guys know we had a cat, but when I got pregnant with Everly, my allergies acted up so bad, and I didn't know that during pregnancy you can develop allergies. I used to never be allergic to cats, but like I said, when I got pregnant with Everly, my allergies were so bad, and I tried to hold off as best as I could, but I just couldn't do it. So our cat is actually now living with Benny's family, so we didn't get rid of him or anything. We still see him. He just lives with them now, but I couldn't do it. If you guys saw like my Instagram updates and stuff when we had the cat, my allergies were so bad. My eyes were super swollen. They were crying nonstop. So my eyes looked so bad. Like the skin around my eyes were red. They were raw. My nose was super running. I was congested. I was having trouble breathing. It was just so bad. So I'm scared that I will also be allergic to dogs because I haven't really been around dogs. So my allergies are just kind of like putting me off from getting pets, but also just because, like I said, they're just a big responsibility. So no pets, at least for a while. How long did it take for your channel to start making money? I believe it took around like 10 months, somewhere around there. With COVID happening, who are you allowing to see the baby? So this is another question that I've been getting a lot. So I think we're only going to have like immediate family. We've been seeing like Benny's mom, my mom. We've still been seeing them. We've all been like really careful. We wear our masks whenever we go out. I try not to go like in the public and all of that stuff. Same thing with like my mom and my sisters. They don't really go like out and about. So we've all been practicing like social distancing and stuff. But I think we also want people to get tested before seeing baby girl. And then we also want masks to be worn whenever they meet baby girl. Who's going to watch the girls when you go into labor? My mom is going to have the girls. Do you think Rory will have any issues adjusting to sharing you with baby girl? Honestly, yes, you guys. Rory is extremely attached to my hip. She's always right next to me. As you guys saw, she was sitting in my lap in the beginning of this video because she was in the other room and she didn't want to be over there. She's actually sitting right next to me right here. Even if I go like take a shower or something, she will literally come in the room and sit on my bed and wait for me to get out. How long do you plan on homeschooling? So I get this question a lot too, and I'm honestly not sure. I was actually considering putting Layla in public school this year before the pandemic happened. Layla was asking me about going to public school. She wanted to try it, and I always want to, you know, respect her wishes. I don't ever want to force her like to be homeschooled if that's something she doesn't want. So me and Benny had talked about it, and we were planning on enrolling her in public school. Shortly after making that decision of putting Layla in public school, this whole pandemic started, this whole coronavirus happened, and as soon as that happened, immediately I knew I was not going to enroll her in public school. I knew this was probably going to get bad really quickly, so I immediately emailed Layla's teacher and I told her that I wanted to keep her enrolled in homeschool for another year. And I'm so glad that I made that decision because Benny was actually kind of hesitant on it. He was like, it's only the beginning of the year. She's not going to be in school like for months. This whole coronavirus could be, you know, dead by now, could be over, things could be back to normal. But thankfully, I pushed for her being homeschooled. And here we are now, months later. COVID is still a real thing. A lot of schools are doing like homeschool now. So I'm so thankful that I made that decision really quickly. And I kept her enrolled in homeschool because a lot of the schools out here in California are doing like distance learning. So I think a lot of it is still online. And then the schools that are open, you have to wear a mask at all time and the children are not allowed to like play together. They have to social distance. And personally, I just don't see that happening, especially with younger children like Aurora's age. Where do you shop for baby clothes? So I shop all over the place. Target, Old Navy, Kate Quinn shop, Little One shop, Literally just like all over the place. I actually just recently filmed a huge baby haul, so I'll have that video linked right here so you guys can check that out, because I linked like everything that I shared in that video, and then I shared like a few shops where I shop at. Does Benny plan on getting out of the military? No. His re-enlistment actually is coming up in September, I believe. So he's re-enlisting for a couple more years. I think the plan right now for him is to retire in the military. What are your current goals? So my current goals right now is to hit 50,000 YouTube subscribers. That's my goal for our channel. And then I also have goals for our house. Like, I want to fix up the backyard really nice. I want to plant a tree for Everly back there. I want to start saving up like a college fund for the girls. I want to start saving up for a bigger house in the future for us. Just, I want to work on like things for our family. All right guys, well that is actually it for today's video. That's all of the questions I'm going to answer today. If you guys are still wondering something, or you have like a comment, anything, just leave it down below and I will try to get back to you guys as quickly as possible. I definitely recommend you go over and follow me on Instagram as well, because every single Friday I do Friday chats where I just chat with you guys, answer questions. I just dedicate my whole Friday to talking with you guys. So definitely go ahead and follow me over there if you aren't already. And as always, if you guys enjoyed this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. Make sure you guys are subscribed to the Mrad Family. And make sure you hit that bell. That way you guys always get notified every single time we upload. And I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye. See you, bye.
Bye. We've had this conversation and you seem to agree with me, but when there's complications, you withdraw and leave me to be.